like it here. You know, there's a line at the unemployment office that you can go stand in. Or, you know, if you had a good experience, you know, you shouldn't have trouble finding another job. But this place, you know, it's a good place. And you got a couple, one man right there that, you know, he runs a tight ship. And, you know, it's not that hard to keep that ship, you know, afloat. So I appreciate everyone coming out today. Tomorrow will be my last day. But if I don't see y'all tomorrow, thanks for everything. Thanks for putting up with me. I mean, I did take this job, my job, serious. And if I was a pain sometimes, you know, I'll apologize right now. If it was worth it, you know, if anybody learned something from me or from a mistake or something, then it was well worth it. Mm-hmm. And thank you.
All right. Anybody else?
I'd like to say something for my dad. Can I make people?
Hey guys, my name is Frank, also. I'm taking his place, so nice to meet everybody. In the name of the Lord, his name, there's no problem. No, my dad, man. If you ever had any interaction with my pops, y'all know he's an awesome man. And speaking for my brothers, you talked about, you know, measure twice and cut once. Man, my mother heard that all through my teenage years, but my dad drug me out to go work with him when I was like 14 years old. Come on, we're gonna do some work and stuff. And I was like, where are we going? Don't worry about it. Let's go. That meant we're working outside, you know. If he told me what the details are, that means we were inside in air conditioning, but if not, we're gonna be outside. But before I say that, I'll tell a quick little story. I have a granddaughter. She's 4 years old, right? And one day we were washing my car, and she said she wanted help. So I said, okay, we'll wash the rims. So she washes the rims, and she comes to the next one. I'm like, you're done already? And she goes, yeah, Grandpa, I'm done. And look, I said, it's not done right, just do it right. So she goes, I did, Grandpa. I said, quit soap, do it right. So then she goes over, she goes to the next one. She goes, Grandpa, I think I'm done. I said, are you sure? And she goes, I think so. She goes, because if I come over there, it better be right. She goes, hold on. So she goes and she starts to, she goes, okay, I'm done. Come over there. And I look and I said, yeah, it looks good. Let me show you, you know, where you missed that. You know, she's only four, you know, but I was making sure she understood. So, you know, I show where she missed that and stuff. I said, look, Mila, we're going to do something, do it right, okay? I said, anything you do, if it's going to be a tire, if it's going to be whatever you do, do it right. And I learned that from this man. That was the word that my dad told him. If you're going to do something, do it right. You know, if you're going to cut, measure twice to cut once, whatever you do, do it right. If it's going to be something small, if it's something, you know, as simple as washing a tire or whatever, do it right, because that's your name on that, you know? And that's something my dad taught us, taught my brothers and stuff like that. And I hold that true to this day. You know, I have people that work for me and stuff like that. And I give that same story to them and stuff. And but this man taught us a lot, man. And I'm very proud of him. I'm very proud of this, you know, to see you guys here and stuff. And he worked a lot of years, hard years. And I know he worked his tail off to put a roof over our head and put food on the table and stuff. And he deserves this little break. I knew he was going to get back to work. He ain't going to retire long. I know. Maybe at Home Depot somewhere is working. It won't last very long, but I know that the time that he is going to be retired, he's going to enjoy it. He earned it. So thank you guys very much for being here.
Thank you.
Even though, you know, us plumbers, you know, we're your nightmare. We cares enough about me. And you guys just come back and just put it back the way it was originally, and even better. So I just want to thank you. I've enjoyed every moment, all the laughs we've had, all the kidding around we have, especially, you know, you and Buddy over here, Frank, you know. But I just hope you come back and visit us. So we can continue the joy that we've had. But this is also your other side of the family too. You have your family. This is always going to be your family.
Christmas.
So yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
I want to say something real quick too. Just, you know, I've known Frank since I started here, I think, and back with the Mayor's Office Special Events, and the plumbing group, the electrical group, and your group were always the team that held that, you know, made everything possible for what we did. But even in this last few years, what I can say from the previous director is that every time he talked about the trades group in general, he bragged about how well and how good of a job our group did, that he always had accolades for all the work that you guys did. Because he said not even contractors, he would prefer for our guys to go in and do the job than give it to a contractor, because you guys did an amazing job. So I just wanted to let y'all know that.
Well, I have a little story to share with y'all. Frank, I called him on the phone one day. I said, Frank, I need help. He said, what's the matter? I said, I need you to come to my house and see something that I have that my husband started and he can't finish it. And I'm going, he said he could do this. And I went and bought all the material, and he built that room with some slants. And I said, and he can't put those things up. They just don't fit. So I need help. I don't care when, how, what time you can come. Please come. I think your son came with you, and they did it in no time, and that room looks beautiful. Talk about perfection. Thank you, Frank. I have your private number, and I will be calling you if I need to again. I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for taking me out of that situation that we were in, and my husband didn't even complain. He just said, okay, bring him. He knows what he's doing, Solomon. You don't. So, thanks a lot. Appreciate it. And all the time you help me. All I have to do is say, Frank, this needs to be done. I need this many. Here it is. And boom, they're done. Thank you. Thanks a million.
And
I know we're going to miss you.
Thanks for sending me for Astro tickets.
Keep in mind if I did more, okay?
Anybody else?
Yeah, we have to stand up.
I'm late. That's all right.
I hate to see you go. I always tell them, come after me, leave before me. I don't get that one, Frank.
Oh.
I ain't gonna let you go, Mr. Tino, when you're in here somewhere.
Yeah, because you took too long.
Okay, I'll make it shout. I ain't gonna let your wife say what Tino's wife said. Now you can go home with her. Before you need to go home, I know me and you had some rough edges. And we resolved it, and then you started talking to me more, so I'm going to bring this one up that you told me once. You were worried about this job so much, every time you would go home, you couldn't hardly sleep. And you told me this, you said one time you went home and you tried to rest, and your wife woke you up, you were fighting her in your sleep. You remember you told me that? Worried about this job, so don't go home, Frank, when you retire. Do you remember telling me that?
Yeah.
It was just, you had a load on you. Like I said, I would, you know, help you as much as I could.
We all want to hear that. You can just talk together.
Well, I enjoyed working with you. Now I got got the movie step. It was Mr. Tino, before Tino. Now I'm starting over Mr. Tino. Frank gone now. So eventually, there you go. Thank you, Mr. Say that again, Mr. Tino.
You're next.
All right, nice to meet you.
Tommy don't have nothing to do with Robert Jones Jr. Try somebody to stay and work that long, they just may not plan to retire.
Any song?
Oh.
Got you a little something there. My name's Frederick. I'm a third son of my dad's. You know, growing up, like my brother was saying, my dad, he put us to work at a young age. That's something that I think my grandpa put in my dad to make us hard workers. So, you know, most kids on Saturday mornings, they watch cartoons and sleep in, but we didn't have that privilege. We were up at 6 o'clock and we were in the old Suburban and we went to work. And that's what my dad did. But you know, a lot of things, it was funny because, you know, we're from South Houston, so I always saw my dad as rough man, you know, hood man, from the hood. And so, but we'd get these jobs and they were in River Oaks, West University, places like that. And I used to say, man, Dad, you know, how you get these jobs? You know, how do they know you? But it was because he had good quality work and he got good referrals. And so, tell you a little quick story. My dad, we always laugh about this. But one time we were working out there, my dad always told me, no matter what's going on, we might have a little downtime, but always look busy. You know, make sure you're always looking busy so they won't complain or anything. So we're over there working, it's hot outside and whatnot, and a lady, the owner, tells my dad, Frank, would you like a beverage? And then my dad says, that would be refreshing. I couldn't stop laughing. But you know, right then and there, that showed me, man, my dad has class. He can mix it up with the guy, the Vatos in the Barrio, and he can mix it up with the classic people in River Oaks. You know, it didn't matter. He knows how to handle it. And whenever we would work, you know, we'd do things and I would see something that maybe he didn't see. And I would always like speak up or recommend something. Like, hey Dad, maybe we should do this or maybe we should do that. And man, he always listened. That's one thing I was always proud of, that my dad always listened and he took my advice. I was a little kid, I didn't know what I was doing, but he saw something that maybe I saw, or he saw something in me that maybe I didn't see, but that gave me so much confidence growing up as a man that now I'm confident in the things that I do because my dad instilled that in me. So I hope hearing all these good stories from y'all, it's great, and I know my dad left an impact on y'all. So thank you, Daddy.